I completed coordination with the help of nervous system. Now I will explain about coordination with the help of endocrine system. In previous class I explained human body. In human body, coordination brought by nervous system and endocrine system. Endocrine system includes endocrine glands. Endocrine glands. So these endocrine glands releases hormones. These hormones which bring coordination in human body. Endocrine glands also known as ductless glands. Endocrine glands also known as ductless glands. They does not have ducts. They release hormones directly into blood. Blood carries hormones from one place to another place. Why we have two systems which bring coordination in human body means nervous system will bring coordination in between of different organs which present in our body. But endocrine system means hormones which bring coordination in deeper parts of the body, which present inside of the body. Now I will start the topic. Chemical coordination. Chemical coordination. What is meant by chemical coordination? The coordination with the help of hormones is known as chemical coordination. Coordination without nerves is known as chemical coordination. Hormones which bring coordination in between of different organs of human body. Now I will explain the how coordination brought by chemicals. A scientist called Paul Langerhans. He is the professor of pathology in Freiburg University, Germany. He is the first person, Paul Langerhans. He is the professor of pathology in Freiburg University, Germany. He noted he researched on pancreas. Already we learned about pancreas in first lesson. So if you will observe like this, if you will observe here, this is pancreas. We know that this is duodenum. On the left side of duodenum, we can find out pancreas. Paul Langerhans is the professor of pathology in Freiburg University, Germany. He researched on pancreas and he noted that, he means Paul Langerhans, certain cells in pancreas which differ with other cells. Certain cells in pancreas which differ with other cells richly supplied with blood vessels. Richly supplied with blood vessels. So these cells differ with other cells. He researched on that cells. He named that cells are islets of Langerhans. Islets of Langerhans. Langerhans discovered these cells, so that's why he named that cells are islets of Langerhans. Islets of Langerhans are the cells which is present in the pancreas, which is different with other cells, which is supplied with blood vessels. After that, several scientists research on pancreas and they removed the pancreas of experimental animal. When pancreas is removed, they develop a disease, they suffer with a disease known as diabetes. After that, some scientists tried the pancreatic duct. We know that pancreas have ducts. They tried the pancreatic duct. So when pancreatic duct is closed, so pancreatic juice will not release into the duodenum. So the pancreas will be spoiled. So after that, 10 years later, three scientists called Banting, Best and McCloy. These three scientists collects fluid from degenerate pancreas. And they give the fluid to the dog which suffers with a disease called diabetes. So when the fluid given to the dog, this fluid helps to decrease the sugar levels. So based on this, they concluded that pancreas, means your islets of Langerhans, releases a hormones, two hormones. Here I will write the hormones, islets of Langerhans. The cells which present in pancreas, which is different with other cells known as islets of Langerhans. These islets of Langerhans releases two hormones. One is insulin. Do you know islet means island? We know that island means we can find out four sides water, middle land. Here islets of Langerhans means the cells which present in the pancreas, which differ with the other cells known as islets of Langerhans. Islets of Langerhans releases two hormones. One is insulin and second one is glucagon. Insulin and glucagon. What is the function of insulin? Insulin helpful to convert extra glucose. Insulin converts extra glucose into glycogen. Insulin is the hormone which released from islets of Langerhans, which helpful to convert extra glucose into glycogen and stored in liver. Another hormone, that is glucagon. What is that? Glucagon also released from islets of Langerhans, which helpful to convert glycogen into glucose. So there are two hormones which released from islets of Langerhans, that is insulin and glucagon. This insulin helpful to convert extra glucose into glycogen and stored in liver. And glucagon is a hormone which released by islets of Langerhans, which helpful to convert glycogen to glucose. So these are the two hormones which released from islets of Langerhans was discovered by Paul Langerhans. He is the professor of pathology in Freiburg University, and he noted that the some cells in the pancreas richly supply with the blood vessels. Already I explained endocrine glands, also known as ductless glands, they release hormones directly into blood. So this blood vessels, blood carries hormones from one place to another place. So this is about insulin and glucagon. Do you know, if insulin is not released, what will happen? Blood glucose levels increases. That condition is called diabetes mellitus. Already we learned about diabetes insipidus in fourth lesson. That is due to deficiency of vasopressin. This is diabetes mellitus, is deficiency due to insulin. When insulin is not released, what will happen? Extra glucose does not convert into glycogen. So the amount of glucose in the body will be increases, which leads to cause a disease called diabetes mellitus. Diabetes mellitus is a disease which occurs in people if insulin is not released. Do you know, children, here we are discussing about gland pancreas, the cells in the pancreas known as islets of Langerhans. Do you know, already we learned about pancreas in first lesson. Some people got some doubt about pancreas. Some people thought pancreas, we discussed about pancreas in first lesson. No, we learned some glands in first lesson, that is salivary glands, gastric glands, and liver, pancreas, intestinal glands. No, all these glands are exocrine glands. Now we are discussing about endocrine glands. No, why pancreas called as endocrine gland? Means if you observe in pancreas, pancreas known as mixed gland. Pancreas known as mixed gland. Why pancreas called as mixed gland? Means it can act as, it can act as both, it can act as both exocrine and endocrine gland. Some part of the pancreas acts as exocrine gland, some part of the pancreas acts as endocrine gland. That's why pancreas called as mixed gland. Some part of the pancreas releases enzymes like exocrine gland. Some part of the pancreas releases hormones like endocrine gland. That's why pancreas called as mixed gland. So this is about first gland in the endocrine system, that is by islets of Langerhans. These islets of Langerhans first observed by a scientist known as Paul Langerhans. He is the professor of pathology in Freiburg University, Germany. He noted that some patches of cells in the pancreas richly supplied with blood vessels which differ with other cells. He named that cells as islets of Langerhans. When pancreas is removed in experiment animal, in that animal blood sugar level increases. Means the pancreas have a relation with the blood sugar. Okay now. Why? Because pancreas, islets of Langerhans in the brain, the pancreas, which releases two hormones, insulin and glucagon. Insulin output converts extra glucose into glycogen. If insulin is not released, blood glucose level increases. That condition is called diabetes mellitus. Now I will explain about another chemical coordination, that is adrenal gland. Second endocrine gland, that is adrenal gland. Do you know, adrenal gland present on top of kidney. Adrenal gland present on top of kidney. If you look at the adrenal gland, we can find out two parts, that is outer part and inner part. Outer part called cortex, inner part called medulla. There are two parts in the adrenal gland, that is cortex and medulla. Cortex releases two hormones, that is cortisol and aldosterone. Cortisol and aldosterone. Cortisol helpful for metabolism of carbohydrates, proteins, fats. So cortisol is a hormone which releases from cortex of adrenal gland outer part, which helpful for metabolism of carbohydrate, proteins, fat. Aldosterone is a hormone which releases from cortex, the outer part of adrenal gland, which helpful for reabsorption of water in the body. There are two hormones which secreted by outer part of adrenal gland, that is called cortex, known as cortisol and aldosterone. Cortisol helpful for metabolism of carbohydrates, proteins, fats, and aldosterone helpful for reabsorption of water. Now the inner part is called medulla. Here medulla releases only one hormone, that is called adrenaline. This is very important, adrenaline.
Do you know, when a roaring dog approaches you, some changes occurs in your body. Can you tell that changes which occurs in your body when roaring dog approaches you? Some changes, that is, our heartbeat may increases, rate of respiration may increases, pupil size may increases, and goosebumps also may increase. Goosebumps also may appear. Sometimes bladder will be empty, rectum will be also empty. What are the changes? Why all these changes occurs in human being? With the help of a hormone known as adrenaline. That's why adrenaline also called as fight or flight hormone. Adrenaline also called as fight or flight hormone. Means, are we familiar with the cock fight? Kodi punjula fighting appudu ganaka chuste, we can find out how they paurusham anedi. What is the reason for this means? This hormone known as adrenaline. If any that situation occurs, human beings will do two things. One is fight with that situation or escape from that situation. For these two reasons, this hormone is responsible. That's why adrenaline, also called as fight hormone or flight hormone. Why adrenaline is called flight hormone or fight hormone? Why? Because this hormone responsible for fighting or escaping in that situation. That's why adrenaline also called as fight or flight hormone. So this is about adrenal gland. In the next class, I will explain about some more hormones in endocrine glands. Okay. Thank you, children.